Oh, okay. Hey, this is cool. Hey, I'm big. Yeah.
So you said the lighthouse, Carlos? Or?
I said the ducks and like a nature
Oh,
walk.
the ducks.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I can't believe it's snowing. Look at the ducks. Oh, it's a big. Oh, why do you have a red mark? Who hurt you?
But I'm not sure they like apple, but red is not good for them. I will give them a melon.
That's sweet. Oh, look at, there's already a duck here.
Hey. Hey. Hey, they like it.
Nice.
Oh. Hello, ducks. Ah, they like me now. Yeah, my investigation started with the curiosity of our perception of space, and also because, yeah, funny that we are talking now in the virtual duckland, but that we live in such a world that it's so interconnected, like the digital world is reaching really much into the into our physical surroundings. So I was just wondering if I could make a work that tries to play with this duality, and then also just to see how mental space and virtual space collide or not. Something like that, and then I just wanted to do a simple research in making the same base shape, like a physical shape, from different materials, and therefore, like I create different sound possibilities and frequencies for the object, so I can digitally interact with these objects in a different way that really connects to their very physical characteristic. And can I do something else than feeding them with watermelon? Or I mean, they are ducks, so what could I do with them? I'm a monster and they are ducks, so like, for example, ceramics, what is the digital version of a ceramic pot that I don't really know. So, what? How can I extend a metal object into digital space apart from its visual extension? But what is the core connection? But sound has this ability to be present in both worlds in a very easily graspable way. So when somebody reaches to an object and then they touch these sounding cones. Then they are confronted with the very physicality of these objects and tangibility of sound as they feel the vibration of the objects very strongly and they can see the objects moving a bit. Or in generally, in most of my works, my intention is to raise questions about our intuition and perception of physicality and physical tangible materials. But I would like to use digital media as a support to reawaken this intuition. Vision towards physicality because digitalization is something that we apparently cannot really avoid, but maybe there are possible ways of using it in a way that actually it can help us getting a more full life experience and not really distracting us from a full life experience. So that's what I'm looking for with art, I think.
Oh, are you worried that we will lose a lot of physical aspects in our life, or
I think we already did. We already did. I'm not necessarily afraid because I also think that humans have this very strong connection to physicality and to, yeah, like nature in terms of like trees and other living beings. Like, I think it's very strong in humanity, of course, but just like when I sometimes I get a message from my phone, like that my average screen time per day was like 1.5 hours a day on my phone. And then I question like, okay, so in that 1.5 hours, I was physically not really present. Yeah, and then now that I have a son who is 3 years old and now he's still quite distant from it, but there will be one age when it will be very hard for me to control that how many hours and how does he spend with computers and screens. And it would be a pity that he sees like certain like animals or nature or just the beach, if he sees like certain things very often more for the first time online and in a virtual reality than in real life.
Yeah, definitely.
Then it would be so nice if he could experience sand, walking in the sand, and not like meeting the sand in a video or in a game or I don't know. So I'm not really worried because people are quite, sometimes people can be also very, very connected to physical things, but still, I think it's nice. It's really time to at least raise questions. I think it's maybe everything is about maybe consciousness or how do you, maybe any tools could be used, but just how do we use it and how do we make other people use it?
Yeah, and how to like.
I don't know. And what do you think? What do you think about what do you think of the role of the screen? Or is it something that should be limited? Or is it something that just should be changed? Or
I think like also what a lot of like artworks are doing is that like there's a really big focus on function, so and ease. So a lot of the ways we are using screens is like making things easier and faster. And in a lot of things about physicality, like you need to take some time, touching or stroke your hand over something. So I find it kind of interesting, like that there's like a bit of a contrast of using a screen or using technology and living in the moment or looking at nature, while everything actually is just a life experience, you know. So there must be ways to combine these things because there's no reason for it to have a contrast. And I hope that there are ways of technology that, for example, maybe they start abstract like your work, like it's combining something digital with a physical object. And I hope that these kind of things give inspiration for maybe also designers to think, okay, that we can put these technological aspects in everyday objects and in like normal functional things. So it becomes something more, you know?
Yeah, I think I like this idea a lot. Also, I would just, like my exploration also of electronics or digital media in art research is also like based on a very friendly approach. So I'm not sure, I'm not in the position of criticize technology or technological developments or evolution, but I'm just raising questions like exactly how it could support us in a full life experience instead of limiting our world. Because I feel that just a simple mobile phone and a laptop in an average user's life, for me it's limiting, at least personally. I think it's always probably a good question because it's so much intuition related, and I think it's like a child is enjoying just immersing in a world of like playing with stones or drawing like a simple drawing or just creating this energy of creating and like trying to playing around and things are evolving around you. It's just humans enjoy it. So I also really enjoy it and I don't really know why, but it's something that like working with material, it's just, I'm really like, I get really in a kind of a balance, even though sometimes, of course, art puts you out of your comfort zone a lot, but just to be close to material and working with it and like being next to the process and really let the material guide me, and then I still try to shape it. So this relationship I just really enjoy also. Like the work that you see here at the Common and our exhibition is actually the work that is less influenced by process. Usually my other works are more intuition related, and this was quite conceptual from the beginning, and it didn't change much through the execution. So it's very an atypical work in ways of making for me. So usually I'm following the material that I started, let's say pouring a sheet of clay on a big plaster sheet, and then I see how it breaks, and then I react to it, and I can add another material. I can decide to fire it, I can decide to glaze it, I can decide to recycle it. So then I can constantly, one reaction of a material has put me in a new position that I have to like relate to it. So that's something I really enjoy. Good to sometimes step out of usual usual ways of doing, and then okay, let's try another way. And then I'm the end. You can reach me. Yeah, I think the easiest is just to check my contact on my website, which you can find on the exhibition flyer, or not, maybe just not there. But if I say it now, like ildikohorvath.com, that's bit difficult for me.
Oh, I can see your name here, so people can spell it out. So it's ildikohorvath.com.
Exactly. And .com. So I think with my name, that just would work.
Yeah,
thank you
so much.
Thank you.
Really wonderful. Super cool.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you can run into the ocean.
Yeah, where we
And now I'm in the...
Bye.
Thank you for stopping by. Thank you for being in the exhibition.
It takes some time because
it just goes on. Oh no, it's endless.
You will be there forever. Walking.